Now I'm heading into town to ship a rug. I had to go to the post office. And now normally, like when I list these rugs, I list them with the postage included, and I have to kind of take the best guess at it. And I usually figure around 10 bucks covers anywhere in this country. That's what it used to be anyway. But one time I was doing 8 and that worked. But then lately now, you know, the postage keeps creeping up kind of. Because I know it on the average it costs me about 12 bucks to ship one now. So I usually end up taking about a $2 beating on the postage every time I mail something. And I hate to, you know, I hate to keep jacking the postage up because, you know, it gets to be a point in there where there's resistance just because of the shipping. I know, like, I don't ship out of the country for the same reason. I know I've had people from, like, New Zealand, somebody wanted to buy one. It would have been like a $60 rug and it would have cost about $80 to ship it. Well, you can't do business like that. So I pretty much stayed just in this country. But, like I say, the postage keeps creeping up to the point where it's actually a little on the, you know, hard side to do business that way. So rather than fight it, I do just eat that $2. And now today, the post office, I think we're going to probably lose our local post office, so I'll have to go to a different town a little further away. And I know they cut back the hours at the post office because last year the post office lost, you know, the whole mail service lost about $16 billion. You know, the post office has always made really bad decisions business-wise. I mean, business-wise, they're a horrible business. You know, they do a good job at delivering mail. But from a business angle, they're absolutely horrible. They make some of the poorest decisions imaginable. You know, like they claim now that email is cutting into their costs so bad because nobody is mailing letters anymore. Well, honestly, if they'd have been smart, they'd have got into the email business right in the beginning. You know, I mean, they could have, instead of going to AOL or somebody, you could have had postal service email. You know, it would have been, you know, people would trust the post office more. I don't know if they would anymore, but of all the bad decisions they made, the one of them was to advertise. Okay, now, if you've got a monopoly, there's no point in advertising. You know, you're going to get that business regardless. But they went and poured all that money into, well, all kinds of advertising, but their worst boondoggle was in that Lance Armstrong. You know, they poured a lot of money into his racing team, which they'll never see again. It could make absolutely no difference in the quality of the mail, or the, you know. But the money they poured into them that they have now lost, they're making up for it in postage. So the way I see it, I'm going to take a $2 beating on this when I mail it. But Lance Armstrong owes me $2.